There is progress to terraform Mars from companies like SpaceX. We also have good concepts to establish a moon base for our future space travel. But is it possible to terraform another planet which has similar characteristics to Earth? We are discussing whether it is possible to terraform Venus in today's video of DiscoverZen. Venus is a planet sometimes referred to as the evil twin of Earth because of its harsh atmosphere. But it has many similarities with our blue planet. The radius, mass, and gravity of Venus are 95%, 82%, and 90% respectively when compared to Earth. Fair enough for any carbon-based life to exist. But it's only the atmosphere, which does not allow Venus to sustain life unless we perform some tremendous engineering. Some of the issues with Venus are: the atmosphere of Venus is extremely hot and thick. It consists of 96% carbon dioxide and 4% nitrogen, including other gases. The thick clouds of sulfuric acid completely cover the planet. The atmosphere traps a small amount of energy from the sun that reaches the surface. It also traps heat the planet releases. This greenhouse effect has made the surface and lower atmosphere of Venus one of the hottest places in the solar system. You would not survive a visit to the surface of the planet. You can't breathe the air, you would be crushed by the enormous weight of the atmosphere, and you would burn up due to surface temperatures, which is high enough to melt lead. Venus does not have any magnetospheres similar to Mars. This means that there is no protection from solar radiation. And another problem with Venus is that it's too close to the sun to be positioned in the so-called Goldilocks zone. Because of this reason, the temperature can fry anything, as it can reach up to 470 degrees Celsius or 878 degrees Fahrenheit. In some studies, scientists have discovered that 30 to 40 miles or 50 to 60 kilometers above the surface of Venus contains an Earth-like atmosphere. At this level, both oxygen and hydrogen rise above the heavy gas layer covering the ground, and the pressures are similar to our planet. Also, there is a proposal that we can establish cloud cities at that altitude. For this video, we are more interested in terraforming Venus instead of floating in the sky. The first requirement is the removal of sulfuric acid and a tremendous amount of carbon dioxide from the planet. If we introduce certain chemicals, it can react with those gases and form water. One possibility is by nuking the planet with hydrogen bombs. A hydrogen bomb can produce water and graphite after reacting with carbon dioxide. The drawback of this plan is that it will create a lot of methane gas too, so it's not a good idea. We can even introduce some matter from Earth to the atmosphere of Venus, which can work as a sink for carbon dioxide and other gases. In this case, the carbon dioxide is simply stored on the surface of Venus, similar to what trees do on Earth, and this will require a lot of materials that are not available on Earth, but can be found in certain asteroids. This can even lead to the atmosphere becoming thinner so that it can support life. There are some other theories too. One of them is to add some bacteria to the atmosphere, but these are highly unlikely to work as the surface of Venus can kill every carbon-based life instantaneously. Other problems that must be controlled on Venus are its temperature and solar radiation. The temperature can be controlled by placing a giant mirror in space near Venus, but that seems impossible anytime soon. If we are able to remove all the greenhouse gases from Venus, the temperature might be livable for any carbon-based life, but the planet will need active maintenance even if everything works fine. Regarding the protection against solar radiation, we can deploy special magnetic field-producing satellites to orbit around Venus. This idea, in theory, can provide shielding from solar flares which causes solar radiation. Do you think that we will need a lot of engineering to terraform Venus, and it's not possible anytime soon? Let's speculate about a scenario that is possible with our present-day technology. What if we terraformed Mars? That seems like a different video to speculate and investigate on DiscoverZen.